Now at 6, more than a dozen veterans in Northeast Indiana say they're victims of medical malpractice at the VA. We look into their lawsuit in a 15 Finds Out report.
Fort Wayne police say they're closing a cold case after the man they believe to be the suspect died. His mother argues it should not be closed.
There is more wintry weather on the way, and I'm tracking it for you all ahead in your exclusive 10-day forecast. Wayne 15 News at 6 starts right now.
You're watching local coverage you can count on. This is Wayne 15 News at 6.
An attorney has filed a class action complaint on behalf of about a dozen veterans in Northeast Indiana who were victims of medical malpractice after receiving treatment at the VA. Good evening, I'm Tara Brantley.
And I'm Dirk Rowley. According to court documents, each of these patients received podiatric care and treatment from Dr. Bradley Hammersley between 2009 and 2016.
Wayne 15's investigative reporter Angelica Robinson has been looking into this, and she joins us now with this 15 Finds Out report. Angelica.
Dirk and Tara, Dr. Bradley Hammersley worked for the local VA for more than a decade. Last year, letters went out to more than 100 of his patients informing them that they were victims of medical malpractice. The VA advised them to take legal action, but those patients soon learned their claims would be denied because they were already outside of the 2-year statute of limitations.
Years after undergoing foot surgery,
he reported to me that the blown tendon needed to be removed, and he was going to replace it with a new one.
An MRI, 3 x-rays, said I needed surgery like yesterday.
Patients of Dr. Bradley Hammersley are worse off now than they were before.
My mind got awful scary. I got emotional.
Billy McGuire, a 70-year-old Vietnam veteran, had surgery on his foot in 2012. 6 years later, he was called into the VA office where administrators told him the surgery was not necessary and that therapy would have corrected the problem.
The Dr. Hammersley so-called cut my ankle and went in there, nipped the tendon and made it damaged himself, and then he sewed it back together.
His story echoes that of about a dozen other area veterans, including Robert Swisher, who was enlisted in the Army in 1984, serving his country for nearly 20 years. After undergoing surgery in 2015, he too learned he was a victim of medical malpractice. Swisher says the investigation began after a serious illness forced Hammersley to take a leave of absence.
It kind of hit deep because when you get out of the service, you expect to be taken care of to an extent.
McGuire and Swisher are listed on a class action complaint, along with nearly a dozen other veterans seeking damages for medical malpractice.
A lot of the surgeries were unnecessary. They were performed improperly. There were some very inappropriate medical procedures that were done on these patients' feet.
David Farnbaugh is representing them.
We believe the evidence is going to show that the VA knew long before February of 2018 that Dr. Hammersley was committing malpractice on a widespread basis and didn't inform any of these patients within the statute of limitations period.
In February of 2018, Congressman Jim Banks asked the VA Office of Inspector General to review the circumstances surrounding the allegations. Banks called the findings troubling. 15 Finds Out has learned that more than 100 patients were victims of medical malpractice. Those patients were treated by Dr. Hammersley sometime between 2008 and 2016. But it wasn't until last year that the patients were notified of the improper care. It was too late for them to take legal action.
We're asking that a federal judge declare or issue an order that the federal government cannot bar the claims of these veterans based upon the 2-year statute of limitations.
A spokesperson from the VA declined to be interviewed but did issue this statement. VA Northern Indiana Healthcare System completed an internal review in 2017 of all podiatry cases performed by Dr. Hammersley after staff raised concerns. The review determined that a small percentage of Dr. Hammersley's patients received substandard care. Leaders have contacted all affected veterans to apologize personally, offer additional medical care, and inform them of their options moving forward. Now both McGuire and Swisher are faced with deciding if they want to do corrective surgery offered to them by the VA.
Knowing that I have to go through another operation, is that going to cripple me?
Looking back at the VA, do we really want to go back to it? Do we really trust it anymore?
According to the VA, Hammersley was terminated in May of 2017 following a review of his cases, and the VA has reported him to the Indiana Board of Podiatry. Angelica Robinson, Wayne 15 News.